This is a summary of the CPIC guideline for non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, abbreviated to NSAIDs, and variation in the gene CYP2C9. This video will specifically discuss the recommendations for meloxicam. Videos covering the recommendations for celecoxib, flurbiprofen, ibuprofen, lornoxicam, piroxicam, and tenoxicam can be found on the PharmGKB website and on the PharmGKB YouTube channel. This guideline was published in March 2020. Patients with reduced CYP2C9 function are at an increased risk of experiencing drug toxicity due to increased exposure to meloxicam. Because of this, the guideline recommends that patients who are CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizers with an activity score of 1 begin meloxicam therapy with a 50% dose reduction before titrating upwards. Use of an alternative therapy can also be considered for these patients. Selection of an alternative therapy is recommended for patients who are CYP2C9 poor metabolizers. This is the PharmGKB meloxicam pathway. A link to the pathway is provided in the description below this video. Meloxicam is converted to inactive metabolites in the liver. This metabolism is predominantly carried out by CYP2C9. In patients with reduced CYP2C9 function, meloxicam metabolism is decreased. This increases the concentrations of active meloxicam in the body and puts the patient at an increased risk of drug toxicity. There are over 70 defined CYP2C9 alleles, known as star alleles. Star alleles are assigned an activity value relative to the star 1 allele, which is designated as a normal function allele. The star 1 allele has an activity value of 1. The activity values of a patient's CYP2C9 star alleles can be combined together to make a total CYP2C9 activity score. This activity score is then used to assign a metabolizer phenotype to the patient, as shown in this table and in Table 1 of the guideline. Note that as more evidence becomes available, new star alleles can be added and the functional definition of some star alleles may change. An important caveat for all genotyping tests is that any alleles which are not detected in the assay are designated as star 1. This could include rare increased function, reduced function, and non-functional alleles, which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. Further information about CYP2C9 alleles can also be found on the PharmVar website at www.pharmvar.org. A link to PharmVar is also given in the description below this video. These are the CPIC dosing recommendations for meloxicam, as shown in Table 3 of the guideline. Patients with a CYP2C9 normal metabolizer phenotype will have normal metabolism of meloxicam. These patients can begin meloxicam therapy using the recommended starting dose. This is a strong recommendation. Patients with a CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizer phenotype and an activity score of 1.5 will have mildly reduced metabolism of meloxicam. These patients can begin meloxicam therapy using the recommended starting dose. This is a moderate recommendation. CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizers may have a higher than normal risk of adverse events. This can particularly impact patients with other factors which can affect drug clearance. Patients with a CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizer phenotype and an activity score of 1 will have moderately reduced metabolism of meloxicam. This can lead to higher plasma concentrations, which may increase the probability of drug toxicity. These patients can either begin therapy at 50% of the lowest recommended starting dose before titration upwards, or be given an alternative therapy not primarily metabolized by CYP2C9. This is a moderate recommendation. CYP2C9 intermediate metabolizers may have a higher than normal risk of adverse events. This can particularly impact patients with other factors which can affect drug clearance. Patients with a CYP2C9 poor metabolizer phenotype will have significantly reduced metabolism of meloxicam, which may increase the probability and/or severity of drug toxicity. An alternative therapy should be selected for these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. No recommendation is given for patients with the CYP2C9 indeterminate phenotype. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to meloxicam, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific metabolizer phenotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. CPIC and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of CPIC's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and CPIC websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.